The secondary ticket market, sports, concerts, theater, a $10 billion cutthroat industry. In most states, it's legal. Everyone wants a piece of the pie. Some are happy just to get the crumbs. This is a show about sellers working in the Florida market. They are the crumbs. They are the South Beach scalpers.
I was born a king of fools. Marbles, I got the tickets from the sponsor. 120 bucks. Take it or leave it. Good. But they don't know that when it comes around to love, I always lose. That's why I call myself the king of fools. I was born never to care.
Is that you, Bones?
Yeah, Marbles.
Come on in.
Here, I got the tickets.
Good, good. Let's check it out. There you go.
Come on, Marbles, a short 20.
Ah, come on, work with
Give
me.
Give me the 20, Marbles.
Ah, come
Give
on,
me
work.
The 20. I'm gonna take the tickets back.
All right, hold on. Yeah, all right?
All right, don't do me that way, homie.
Ah, come on, give me a chance.
Every time I deal with this guy, Marbles, it never has a zorda, the dinero, the geld, never has any money. Nothing here, no.
What a stupid sign. Dave.
Stalker's in the back.
See?
Morning. I'm Chris.
What, do you live in a barn?
What do you mean by that? See, you got your feet on the desk. Comfortable?
Bones, he's away, but he asked me to come in. So here I am. So let's take a look at your resume, see what that's all about. Let's see what we got here. It says here you served in the military. Thank you for protecting and serving us. It says here you're armed security guard. You got quite the resume. Weapons expert?
Here's the deal, Chris. These scalpers have become a big problem in our business and other local businesses. What's happening is they're like cockroaches and we can't get rid of them. Bones is hiring you to hopefully scare them off once and for all. In the state of Florida and in most states, it's perfectly legal to scalp tickets. However, what they can't do is they cannot stay on the property of different stadiums and venues if security tells them to leave.
Well, wait a minute, just a minute. I don't work for those people. I got no authority. I got no jurisdiction there.
You know what? They don't know that. Besides, if they get unruly or out of hand, you just call the cops on them. Oh, and by the way, don't call the cops on this guy. This is Bones.
That's all right. I don't like those people anyway. I bought some tickets from them and I got ripped off. So they got it coming.
Hi.
Hey, Steve.
Yep.
You're Steve, right?
Yes.
Yeah, Frank. We spoke over the phone.
Frank, nice to meet you, man.
Great, great. I got your tickets for the Heat game tomorrow night.
Okay,
just
cool.
Like I say, courtside.
Okay.
All right.
I've spent a lot of money on these just to see some kind of ID to know these are real.
You got my number, you know.
Well, anybody has a cell number.
Yeah, here's my card. See my name on it?
Your op card? Okay, we're halfway there. Now you got someone a picture?
Come on, you don't trust me.
It's not a question of trust. A lot of money.
All right, yeah. Make you happy.
Okay, now we're good. Now we're good.
All right, so I get paid.
Hold on to that. Let me go get some money. Give me a minute.
Look at this. Marbles.
What's up, Cabano?
What are you doing here?
I'm here. I got a customer. I'm eating for tickets and stuff.
You got a customer?
Yeah.
No, buddy. That's my customer.
Hey, Harry's here already. He's got
No, listen. I called him. We discussed it. It's my customer. Bottom line, I don't want to talk to you. That's my customer.
Hey, what's up? I take it you're Eddie? Hey, man, I'm sorry. I didn't even think you were going to show. I called Frank. He came with the tickets. He's first up. So I'm sorry, man. It's the way it goes.
You know what? Do me a favor and lose my number and take those tickets and shove them up your ass. And I'm going to tell you something, Mr. Tough Guy. I'm going to get you and throw you around like a rag doll because I've had enough of your This ain't the first time. You got that?
These guys don't get it. They don't like me. I don't understand. Cabano, Bones, the whole gang. I'm not a local guy. So what? Why don't you like me? I can't figure it out.
Hey, take a look at that wall over there. That's our wanted posters. We've been doing surveillance on these guys. Vinny Vice. Just like his name implies, Vinny has a very checkered past. Some call him the Sicilian scammer. Unfortunately for our business, he's trying to clean up his life and has turned to scalping. I liked him better when he was a two-bit hoodlum, but now he shows up at every event that Bones has tickets for. His expertise? Tricking customers through his quick talking and schmoozing? You can't keep your eye off this guy. He's been known to hide under cars to escape security. He's probably the reason the Marlins made a dome stadium to keep this fungus out. Center Ice Bob. This ex-New Yorker represents the trash that can't make it in the Big Apple. Now he's South Florida's problem. They call him Center Ice Bob because his specialty is selling hockey tickets to the Frenchies that visit us in the winter. He works the Hollywood Boardwalk area on the beach, selling them to, especially to the Montreal ones.
Why is that, Stork?
Because they don't speak English too good. That's why. And it's easier for Center Ice to sell them the nosebleeds for a price of a good seat. They don't know no better. They think he's some sort of hockey ambassador for the sport, when in fact, he's just a human funnel who siphons off the French fries. El Cubano. This guy, what a winner he is. If you took all of his fake jewelry and melted it down, you'd get a car. Rumor has it, there was this one time that he sold a ticket to this lady and she shorted him $20. You know what he did? He held her dentures while she went to the ATM to get some money. What a winner. This guy's got a short temper. You gotta watch out. Make sure you pit him against the other scalpers, and that's real easy to do. And it'll take care of itself. Marbles. You'll know this guy by his horrible breath and his distinctive voice. They call him Marbles because when he talks, it sounds like he's got a dozen of marbles in his mouth. This clown was actually kicked out of Philly by other scalpers.
First of all, is that his real face?
Yeah, that's his real face.
So what'd he do to get kicked out of Philly?
It depends on who you talk to, Chris. Some guys said he sold him fake tickets, others said he kept the money, a few said he didn't pay commissions when they tried to broker a deal with his tickets and their clients. He has found so many ways to take people's money, he could write a book.
Well, I could see they smashed his face in before he left Philly.
Well, with all those enemies, it's amazing this guy can even sell tickets. If you could put a face to raw sewage in this guy, would be the poster boy. As you can see, Chris, ticket chick, the picture isn't too clear. She's very elusive, to say the least. She wears her hair in different styles and colors. Plus, we lose a lot of our big paying customers to this lady, who uses her looks to sweet talk some of the middle-aged guys on business who want to go to a basketball game or to a concert in Bayside.
Wow, she's a real looker. I'd like to visit her box office with my ticket stub.
Everything you need is in there. In 2 weeks, I want progress. I get it, you get paid. I don't get it.
But right up front, just like you wanted, I told you over the phone. Good, great seats. You'll
okay,
be happy.
I know that. I know. Am I gonna be blocked though at all?
Nah.
Because
nah.
I got to, you know, I want to make sure I get a good view.
What's this? What's this, huh? Lunch money, right? Yeah, that's funny. Listen, what's going on
I'm
here?
I'm talking to my friend.
You, big guy.
I don't want any problems. Yeah, you know.
Hey, okay, yeah. Give me a minute.
Give me a
minute. Get off my beach. You know what?
What?
Get off my beach.
Come on. I'm almost done.
No, I'm not interested in that. Come on.
Can I get you something to eat? Can I get you lunch?
All right, you can get me some lunch. That sounds all right. I'll tell you what. That's fine. I'll give you a few minutes. You get me some lunch.
I'll be at your post. What? 10 minutes?
Yeah, 10 minutes. Is fine.
I'll catch you over there.
All right, fine.
I'll see you.
Oh, sandwich, chips, and a nice cold water. And that water better be cold.
Don't worry, I'll get good. It's lunch money. I don't know. I take care of him. I buy him a sandwich. I give him something to eat. I figure he'll help me out. I'll be able to work, get it good, have a good circumstance out here. What does it take? The next day, it's the same thing all over again. What do I gotta do? Get him a double meat sandwich, get him dessert?
You know, I always hated these guys. okay? But I gave him $150 for tickets to see Kool and the Gang. We're driving down the road, me and my girl. I open up the envelope of the tickets. It's for Yanni, okay? I hate these f***ing guys.
Thank you for calling.
That's
what's in the summer. I'm going to help you.
Yes, sure. Jack Escott, please. Thanks. Hey, Jack, we spoke on the phone. This is Bones. I got your Skrillex tickets.
That's great. I've only got $180 for you.
$200.
Look, I'm a stand-up comedian. Pretty soon you're going to be selling tickets to my shows.
$200.
How about I tell you a joke? If I make you laugh, I get them for $180. My wife, she's always getting mad at me. The other day, we're at the cemetery. We're paying respects to her parents. She looks at me and says, I wish I could be buried next to my parents. And so I started doing it. I dug a hole, I pushed her in.
$200.
Is there anything I can do to get these tickets for $180?
All right, so you clowns are working the walkway now, is that it? You're interrupting my lunch. No, you're not just talking. 10. 9. 10.
What's 10 mean?
10 means I got my GED and I know how to count and I got a real job and you don't, so get the hell out of here. You're interrupting my lunch. Listen, listen, you guys, I tell you what, I'm going to call the cops and I'm telling you, get out of here.
You know what?
Yeah, that's right. 9. 8. 7. Yeah, that's right. I will enjoy my lunch.
These two guys, this Marbles and this Lunch Money, Lunch Box Mamalukes, they got us thrown off the beach 3, maybe 4 times a week. We're over here trying to make a living. Oh, what? What do you got to do over here? I got my man Cubano. We're gonna make some noise. They think they're gonna roll the beach. Yeah, they ain't gonna reach your guts.
Is there anything I can do to get these tickets for $180? Is there anything I can do to get these tickets for $180?